Hi guys, how are you guys doing? I hope you're having a fabulous day. Thank you so much for tuning in. So I recently went to Delhi, my hometown, my city. And this was actually, I actually paid a surprise visit. Neither did my parents or nor my in-laws. No one knew about it. So it was a really, really good time and it was great. I love giving surprises. Especially now that we've moved to Bangalore, I just love the fact that I'll go unannounced. So guys, my Delhi trip is never complete till I pay a visit to Bangla Sahib, Gurdwara Bangla Sahib, which is in Connaught Place. I'm not like super duper religious sort of a person, but the only place where I find my peace, or the only place where I like to go and worship and really like have faith in, is Bangla Sahib. It's like my happy place. Whenever I go there, like I think I've been there, I've gone there since childhood, and every time I go, I feel at ease, I feel really, really blessed, and I feel really, really grateful. So now that I'm here, every time I visit Delhi, I have to go to Bangla Sahib. That's like a must do for me. So this time also, I went with my mom and my brother. We went to CP and we went to Bangla Sahib. But this time I felt like doing some sort of retail therapy, and as like my last visit, me and my mom had gone to Delhi Haat. This time I told her I wanted to go to Janpath, because we were already in Connaught Place. I thought Janpath is obviously like right there. You know, it's been so many years that I really wanted to go and see what's out there. For those of you who haven't heard about Janpath, or you haven't been there, or you're not from that city, Janpath is one of the most famous markets in Delhi. It's more like a local market. It has stalls of people selling export surplus. It's just one lane, and it also has a lot of shops which sell a lot of local handicrafts and leather stuff and home decor stuff and other decorative items. I absolutely love Janpath, because the clothes that you get there, the stuff that you get there, is very, very inexpensive. There's a lot of bargaining that happens there, and it's really nice. It's like really casual stuff that you can wear for a month or two and just get rid of it. If you are in Delhi, if you go to Janpath, you have to first shop there. You have to go to Deepall's and have their cold coffee. It's a staple there. It's one of the best cold coffees I've had there. Oh my god, I was so happy having that after so many years. It has a lot of clothing, and you know, they actually have stuff that is tagged with proper brand names, from Zara, from H&M, from all of these high street brands. Of course, it's basically export surplus. So what export surplus means, of course, is it might be some sort of defect, or it might be a rejected sample or something, or it could be just a sample, because you know, obviously so much of exports happen from India. A lot of these samples are basically sold at cutthroat prices, and really, really inexpensive prices. So I personally went there this time. I think I went after like at least 7 or 8 years, and oh my god, I had so much fun. While I had really little time, I was pressed on time, but me and my mom went there and I did shop a bit. Again, it was like complete nostalgia for me, because when you've shopped at a place during your college time and your school time and stuff, you know, it's just always so much fun to get back to those places. I was actually quite surprised with the kind of collection these people had. It was actually quite nice. Maybe because, you know, summer has just started in Delhi especially, and in Bangalore, of course, it's already there. And there was such good cotton summer wear stuff that I was quite happy. I have recorded a bit of my visit there. So I'm just going to show you guys first. Just a little glimpse of that market. It's a very casual, informal sort of a vlog. Honestly, I had such little time. I couldn't shoot the entire place, especially the main, the proper shops outside. I mainly shot the inside area of Janpath, where you mainly get all the stuff from. And so it's just a small vlog that I'm just gonna follow. Just check it out, and then I'm gonna just show you guys what all I got.
Hi guys, how are you guys doing? I hope you're having a fabulous day. I've been in Delhi for the past week now, and I haven't had the time to even pick up my camera, pick up my phone to shoot or do anything, because obviously this is downtime with my family and just chilling with them. But today I've come to a place which I absolutely love in Delhi, and I just thought, why not show you guys around. It used to be my most favorite college time place to just shop and hang out and eat. And every time post college, and you know, when you're on a budget and everything, it is one of the most popular touristy places in Delhi. It's Janpath, it's in CP. So if you're from Delhi, of course you know it, and if you're not, then you would have to come here. These are shops of various, again, Indian handicrafts, and there are these small stalls of export surplus. So it's pretty much like your Sarojini, if you've heard of. It's the same thing. You bargain a lot here, and you get a lot of amazing stuff, jewelry, clothes, footwear, Kolhapuri chappals. My entire college time has been I've worn clothes and chappals from here, and absolutely loved them. So I'm just gonna show you guys around. This is where you get a lot of these local clothing, kurtas, tops, pajamas, a lot of nice linen wear. So this is where the main entrance is, and you have all these small stalls. I'm just gonna enter now and show you guys. I don't even know what I want to buy.
This is where the entrance of the market, and there are all these small shops towards till the end, and you get a lot of these amazing export surplus.
So guys, I have, as usual, shopped a lot. This is the stuff that I have. Did quite a bit of random shopping. This stuff you can wear at home or casually. It's just fun to sometimes just go off the malls and buy stuff which are pretty much like you wear it 4-5 times and you're sorted. And I'm gonna do a haul video and show you guys what all I got. So I bought some stuff for myself and some stuff for my mother-in-law.
That was a little glimpse of my visit to Janpath. I hope you guys liked it. It's always a little crowded because a lot of tourists come there. Whatever I could record, I recorded, and just to show you guys a glimpse of what this place is. This really budget haul of mine. I have shopped at this kind of a pricing after a lot of years, and it really made me very happy. I was so excited. So I'm just gonna show you guys what all I got. The one tip that I have for you guys is you have to bargain really hard. And by bargain hard, I mean to say that if someone is saying that a top is priced at 700 or 800, you have to go even way below 50% of the price. Only then will they actually come to an actual figure of a negotiation. The trick that I usually follow is I keep a flat rate for everything. I just say this is the rate, and I will not go beyond it. So without further ado guys, I'm just going to show you guys what all I got from my Janpath haul. Okay, so the first thing that I got is this white cotton shirt. I think when it's summertime, you can't go wrong with whites and cottons. So I buy a lot of whites. I think I have every style of a white shirt now. So this is how this shirt looks like. And what I like about this is this detailing that it has in the bottom. It's pretty much a loose fit shirt. I felt that it was a little big for me, but you know, being summertime, I think I really prefer wearing stuff that's, you know, loose and comfort fit. So this is the white shirt that I got. It's a full sleeve shirt. It's more like actually a quarter sleeve shirt, but what I love is this detailing on it. Now he was quoting me a price of 650 for this, but I bought this for 300. What a price! Like, what do you get in 300? To be honest, I would go to a mall and buy two tops from what I've bought. I think I bought 11 items, and you'll be shocked to know the pricing of these. So this was for 300. The cotton is really nice, and it's not even that see-through, but of course you will have to wear a spaghetti under it. But that's the first thing that I got. The next thing, oh my god, guys, Janpath was flooded with denim shirts like everywhere. Now again, I think this summer again, I think blue and white are the two colors that will always be in every summer somehow. This time again, I think my entire shopping is full of blues, so get ready for a lot of blue overdose. Now, and they had a lot of denim stuff, denim shirts, denim dresses, they had denim plazos, and they had a lot of stuff. So I got this denim shirt. This is again a very easy breezy shirt, but what I like it here is it has a tie knot here. So it's a full sleeve denim shirt, and it's not very very long. This is a short denim shirt with a tie, so with a tie waist like this. This is like a soft denim one, and I really really like it. I love denim stuff, and I love shirts, tops and dresses that, like, especially this soft denim and this lightweight denim stuff, it really looks nice in summers. So this is what I got. Again, this was quoted to me for like 750. Like, they can tell you any price. I usually just laugh at them and tell them, you know, I'm a local here, you don't have to quote me like triple the price. So that's how you need to start bargaining with them. So this was, again, they were quoting 750, and I got this for 300. I will post pictures wearing this stuff on my Instagram, guys. I'm not doing a try on haul. Somehow I don't know, I don't think I can do it right now, but I will do it later on maybe. The next thing again is a blue shirt. This is the next shirt that I got. Again, it's a normal top with buttons on it. It's really really very soft. This is the reason why I bought this, because this fabric was really soft. It is like a full sleeves, but it's a folded three half sleeves, and that's how it looks. Very easy breezy. This is so summer. If I wear it with a nice white pant, it's gonna look really nice. Again, bought this for 300. He was telling me that it's 600, but I bargained it down to 300. So the thing is that you don't get to try there, because obviously there's stalls, so you will not have any space to try things out. So sometimes you have to just guess and just take a size. So, and sometimes even their mediums are so big. For example, this is a medium shirt that I got. It's like a lilac purplish color. Again, this has this kind of a detailing on it. I feel this is a little loose to me. It's quite big actually for a medium, but they didn't have a smaller size, and I really liked it. So I bought a bigger size. I'll probably get it fitted. It doesn't really matter. Or sometimes I personally really like oversized clothes also. I feel when it's summer, you really need stuff that is really loose and, you know, easy breezy. So this is the shirt that I got. Again, bought this for 300. He was saying, I think he started at 750. So the way to bargain hard is you have to walk out of the shop and move to the next shop, and they will keep calling you, they will keep lowering down the rate. Okay, 500, okay, 400, and you know, you have to keep at it. Don't look at them, don't look back. And the moment they'll say, okay, fine, take it, is when you go back and get the price that you have quoted. The next one is very boho. It's really nice. I really, really liked it. Again, it's a blue and white stripe. This is how it looks. I really like it. I love that it has this kind of a tie thing on it, and it has this thread work on it. And it's not very, very long. It's pretty apt in terms of length also. And I really like it. Wear it with a nice blue jeans and you're sorted. Fabric is again very linen-y cotton. Really nice. You need a lot of variety as a girl. So I think for 300, these are all a steal, and I'm really looking forward to wearing these. I think I've already shown you 5 tops and all of them are in the shade in shades of blue. So this is definitely a blue clothing shopping haul. The next one is actually something that I've actually myself seen at Zara. It's very, very similar. This is the top that I got. It's not that long, it's a little short, but it's quite very I found it really pretty. I love the white thread work on it and the sleeves and everything. It looked really nice. Again, I bought this for 300 rupees. Now the next one is again a blue top, guys. I know how many blues that I buy, but there was no other color that was nice there. Especially when you buy it from places like these, some of the colors were really tacky and they look cheap. So you know, you can't go like to experiment too much also there. So again, I bought another blue. This is, but I really like the style of this, and it has this beautiful white thread work on it. Really, the sleeves are a little ruffled sleeves, and this is such a pretty top. I can't wait to wear it. It's so beautiful. The work, it's from the front and back. It has this white thread work and it's looking so pretty on the blue color. This is how it looks, guys. I'm really looking forward to wearing this. I think I bought this for 350 because I think he knew that this was too pretty and I'm not gonna leave it. So I bought this for 350. The size is, I bought medium in everything, but some mediums were really loose, some were really like tight. So it really depends. So you have to be very careful when you buy these things. So guys, this was all the tops that I got. As you guys can see, they're all in shades of blues. Oh my God, this I'm noticing now actually. But they're all pretty much shades of blues. But I actually love blues during summer, so that's not bad. Now the next thing that I got is such a beautiful dress. Again, my love for whites. This was such a beautiful dress that I didn't really think twice. Now it's a spaghetti dress. Yes, this is how it looks. Look at this detailing, guys. This is how it looks. It is such a pretty dress that I can't wait to try this. It's got like this elastic on the back, so of course it's like stretchable from the chest area. And this is such a beautiful holiday dress. Like, makes you want to go on a holiday right now. It's such a beach holiday dress, and actually I can wear it in the city as well. So really beautiful, and I don't think you guys can see it, can you? So this is the detailing that it has all over the dress. This dress has this kind of a detailing, and it actually comes with a slip, which is great because of course white dresses always are see-through. So this is the dress. I'll absolutely love it, and I can't wait to try this on. This was priced at, he was quoting 800, but I got this for 350. Absolutely love this dress. I think this is one of my most favorite buys from my visit to Janpath, guys. I absolutely love it. The fabric is amazing. The next thing is I bought some pants. Cotton pants. So they had a lot of cotton pants, like all over. I think one of the major things that I saw at Janpath were these cotton plazos. So the first one that I got is this. It's so like easy breezy. I can wear it at home. I can go out with a white t-shirt and I'm sorted. Very soft fabric, and it's not even that see-through. I'm really careful about buying lowers in light colors because I just feel, you know, the whites are always translucent. But this is how it looks. It's just such a summer pant. It has elastic. Most of their plazos there are free size. So, but this is just right. The size was just perfect for me. It actually, the tag says it's American Eagle. So yeah, I bought this for 300, guys. These pants are mostly at flat rate, 300 or 400. There's usually no bargaining on it. So this is the first one that I got. Why I like it is the fabric is really soft and it looks really comfortable. Now the next one that I got is actually a linen pant. It's blue in color. I wanted like a basic blue pant that, you know, very casual, everyday wear sort of a pant. So this is how it looks. It's navy blue in color. They have at least 15 to 20 color options in every trouser style. While that was more like a plazo sort of a loose pant, this is more like a ankle length pant. It's not that loose, so it's gonna fit really nice. Again, it has an elastic. And it has a belt on it. Again, bought this for 300 and I absolutely love it. I can't wait to style it for more. A lot of my tops that I've bought can be teamed up with this pant and it's gonna look really nice. Sad part is they didn't have white in this or on those pants. So I was really looking for a white pant, but they didn't have it. I think it was actually sold out. Obviously, summertime, white is the most favorite color of the season. So white was sold out, but this I absolutely love. Last, guys, this is the last item that I got. I don't want to bore you guys with everything that I got. Is another palazzo pants that I got. These are black and white stripes. Absolutely love these. So these are of course some sort of like a polyester fabric, crepe polyester sort of a fabric. I really really like it. I can't wait to style this because this looks so comfortable. It has elastic on the back and it's like, this was again a free size one. It comes with this belt. So you can wear it with a belt and just wear a nice plain white t-shirt and you're sorted. It's going to look really nice. So this is what I got. I actually got the same one for my mother-in-law. This was priced at 400. He wasn't ready to budge at all on the pricing of this. So I got this for 400, but the fabric seems very, very nice. So that's it actually, that's all that I got. Besides this, guys, what I bought is, see, they had amazing cotton kurtis. So I bought like two cotton kurtis for my mother-in-law. They were really beautiful and I bought them for a price of what, 350 each, and they were nice block print cotton kurtas, long length kurtas. They were really pretty and they had so many designs, so many colors. I don't have it right now because obviously I left it in Delhi, but the kurtas were amazing there. Besides this, of course, there was a lot of other stuff. There were dresses, there were jackets, there were pants, there were shorts, there were so many kurta options. Kurtas were amazing. So Janpath again has a lot of junk jewelry options, a lot of stores which have junk jewelry. They have a lot of options of juttis, kolapuri, chappals. I live on Zara's and H&M's, but to be honest, what I've bought this time, I'm so excited to wear all of this. Even if I wear it this summer, I'm sorted. So all in all, guys, if I count all of this, 7 tops, 3 pants, 1 dress and 3 pants. And so that makes it 11 items. I bought these 11 items for on an average 300. So 3300. I think for 3500 or 3700, I've bought all of this, which like 11 outfits in like under 4000 rupees is a steal. It's maddening. Like, can you imagine that? So of course I've got a really really good deal this time and I've really really enjoyed shopping at Janpath. So I really hope you guys like this video. Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. Bye.